Is there any other online platform where the faculty is those who have cleared multiple competitive exams like IBPS PO, IBPS SO, RBI Grade B, CAT, GMAT, and the faculty has teaching experience of 10 to 15 years in which thousands of such students have cracked competitive exam? This is the very reason that in the first year of the course launch, iExamBeat student have huge success. Coming to the 43rd question, a local language enabled workflow based on e-governance system to capture all the activities under MGNREGS is called. The correct answer is NREGS Soft. This is for the workflow of the e-governance system for MGNREGS. Next question, which of the following is correct? Three statement, gross fiscal deficit of the state has declined in last 3 years. Mark your answer. The correct answer is yes, gross fiscal deficit of the states have reduced from 3.5% of GDP to 3% in 17-18 and 2.6% in 18-19. The net FDI has increased in 18-19. This is also correct. But the foreign exchange reserve as on the March 19, has slightly declined from March 18 number, though internal forex reserve is increasing. Understand some important terms. So nominal growth is when inflation is added to it. And this is CPI inflation and WPI inflation. So RBI targets CPI inflation. You can see over the years, the inflation has moderated. This is the foreign exchange reserve, which declined here, further started increasing. And this is net FD. So 91-day yield shows the yield in the short run. And this 10-year, the yield in the long run. During last year, both increased first and then it started declining. Now interest rates are declining. RBI is reducing repo in every monetary policy review. These numbers are old but still may be relevant. GDP growth rate moderated to 6.8% in 18-19 from 7.2 in 17-18. Still, India is the fastest growing major economy, but this is of last year. Macroeconomic stability is maintained and inflation is within the 4% range. And current account deficit also is maintained. Fiscal deficit of the central government stood at 3.4% in 18-19. Current account deficit 2.6% in April to December 2018. Non-performing asset as a percentage of the gross advances reduced to 10.1% in December 18 from 11.5% at the end of March 18 for banks. Which of the following is correct? This is comparatively easy question because statement A, fiscal deficit to be kept by 3% in by 2021, yes, it is correct. And central government plans to keep government debt to GDP ratio 40% by 24-25. This is also correct. And PM Kisan scheme or any other scheme cannot really help in containing the fiscal deficit. Rather, any government scheme where government has to spend will increase the fiscal deficit. So this cannot be correct. So both these numbers, 3% fiscal deficit and 40% debt to GDP ratio, we discussed just now, debt to GDP ratio is 44.5%. In general, central government and state governments are on the path of fiscal consolidation. Remember, this is of the last year view, the current view is changing. And on fiscal front, scheme like PM Kisan has been done without much compromising on the fiscal target. Next question, what is not correct about taper tantrum? Earlier we discussed this about taper tantrum. So what is not correct about it? First, you need to understand what is taper tantrum. It refers to the panic which has happened in the market in 2013 after the investors learned that the Federal Reserve was slowly putting a brakes on the quantitative easing program. So this quantitative easing program was started after the 2008 financial crisis, and in taper tantrum, slowing of the quantitative easing happened by Federal Reserve. This is correct. Therefore, it resulted in the increase in the interest rate in the economy, because during quantitative easing, Federal Reserve was supporting more liquidity in the market, interest rate were less. So Fed announces to reduce the pace of its purchase of the treasury bond, because by purchasing the treasury bond, Fed was supporting liquidity in the market. So the pace of this purchase has been slowed down, tapering of the purchase of securities. US economy collapsed. This is wrong, because the economy suffered this dent during the global financial crisis of 2008, and before this the dot-com crisis of 2000, and before this during the Gulf War also. Our next question, which of the following is called reserve money? Yes, this number is also touched in the economic survey. Answer you may be knowing, it is M0. It is M0. The next question is, which of the following best explains money multiplier? If you understand reserve money, you know this answer also. M3 divided by M0 is money multiplier. Let's understand, M0 is also called reserve money or high powered money. That is currency in circulation plus bankers deposit with RBI or other deposits with RBI. And M1 is currency with public, demand deposit with banks, other deposit with RBI. M2 is M1 plus post office saving. Post office saving was not included in M1. And M3, which is called broad money. Normally, we will talk about M0 and M3. M0 being the reserve money and M3 being the broad money or monetary aggregate. This is M1 plus time deposit, because in M1 it is demand deposit. When you include time deposit in this, that becomes broad money. And M4 also include post office deposit, total post office deposit in M3, that becomes M4. Remember these four exams, and for 3 years you can see the growth in the reserve money M0, and broad money growth has been on declining trend since 2009. See the graph here. It marginally improved here, and when we talk about money multiplier, it expanded sharply between 1996 and 2003, this period. Then it was stagnant or slightly declined. Here it increased and slight decline here also. You can read this para. If there is any confusion, you can ask. Coming to the last question, after August 2018, there had been liquidity crunch in the market. RBI responded to solve this liquidity crunch by OMO, increased FLLCR, reduced SLR. You have these options. If you don't know what is FLLCR, there is a separate video. Go through that. The correct answer is all of these are correct. RBI responded by infusing liquidity through OMOs. RBI conducted 27 OMOs of 2.98 lakh crore billion during the year. RBI increased the FLLCR effective from October 2018, and RBI reduced the SLR by 25 BPS. If the video is helpful, please subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon, and remember, exam hai toh, I exam bhi hai.